So today we're going to be covering circuit simulation with LTSpice, and just so you know, SPICE stands for Simulation Program with Integrated Circuit Emphasis. And that's just a general term for electronic simulation software. There's lots of SPICE simulators out there, and LTSpice just happens to be my favorite. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is Google for LTSpice. The first link will take us to Linear Technology's webpage, and download LTSpice 4. No thanks, just download the software. And boom, you can download it, install it, and let's begin the learning process. Okay, so you've got LTSpice installed. The first thing to do is go to the toolbar over here and click New Schematic. Now, on the toolbar over here, we've got our basic components like resistors, capacitors, and inductors. And we could start laying some down right now. You can use the mouse's scroll wheel to zoom in and out. Okay, that's a good size. Control R to rotate and click. Let's grab a capacitor, put it down, and to add a voltage source, we're going to have to hit F2, which will take us to the advanced component menu. We've got all kinds of things in here, transistors, LEDs, current sources, op amps, but for now we just want a voltage. Boom. And every single simulation you ever do will always need a ground labeled somewhere. So let's put that there. Next, let's wire things up. So hit F3 to enter the wiring mode. And after you're done with each little wire, hit escape. Otherwise, you end up doing weird wiring that doesn't work. F3, click, escape. F3, escape. F3. Escape. So we've got our generic low-pass filter now, so let's add some actual component values. Right-click the capacitor. Let's make this 1 microfarad, and you can put in U for micro. Okay. Right-click the resistor. Let's make it a 1 kilo-ohm resistor. Now, things are going to get interesting when we want to set up our voltage source, because we have a lot of different options in SPICE software. We could just leave it as a DC value, but since we're doing filters here, inherently we want to be looking at AC signals. So let's go to the advanced menu. Lots of different options. For now, we're going to do a small signal AC analysis. And what that'll do is it'll allow us to sweep through AC signals of a wide frequency range and see what happens when you pass them through the filter. Let's give an amplitude of 1 volt and just leave everything else blank. Okay, now we're almost ready to do our simulation, but first we have to go to the Simulate menu and Edit Simulation command. We've got a whole bunch of options here, lots of different simulations you can do with SPICE software. We're going to do AC analysis because that's what we had selected earlier on, where we had that 1 volt AC small signal that we were going to sweep through all of the different frequencies with. Now, we got to choose how are we going to sweep those frequencies. We can sweep by octave, decade, linear. Let's do decade for now. Basically, this is going to determine what you see on the horizontal axis of your bode plot. Number of points per decade. That basically refers to the resolution of points in each decade. And I found that 20 points is perfectly fine and it gets a nice smooth curve. Start frequency, 1 hertz. Stop frequency, let's make that 1 megahertz. Okay. Now you get this little box over here, and you can just put it down anywhere. Okay, we're ready to do our simulation. Simulate, run. Now, at first it looks like it didn't work, but let's go over here, and you can see. You can click on different nodes in the circuit and see the AC sweep on that node. You can also look at the current going through any given component. And if the screen just gets too crowded, just double-click any point and it'll get rid of all the other ones. Very cool. Now you might be wondering, why are there 2 lines? Well, the solid line is the amplitude of the signal, or the magnitude of the signal. And the dotted line is the phase shift of the signal, represented in degrees, whether it's lagging the signal or leading the original input signal. And that becomes more useful in more advanced electrical engineering topics like designing oscillators, RF design, high-frequency digital design, etc. For now, let's just focus on the magnitude of the bode plot, because that's what's going to tell us what the output voltage is for given frequencies and our input voltage of 1 volt. So right now on the vertical axis, everything is shown in decibels, but I'd rather see everything in terms of the absolute voltage. So let's right-click, manual limits, and instead of decibels, let's choose a logarithmic scale. Let's make the top value 2 volts, and on the bottom we have a tiny value already, so we'll just leave it like that. Okay. Great, so you can see that at very low frequencies we have 1 volt. And take a look in the lower left corner over here when I'm looking at the graph. You can see it's showing you the x and y values. As we get into the higher frequencies, there is some attenuation. Now at the y value of 0.7 volts, let's see if I can get it, 0.713, close enough, this should be roughly our cutoff frequency, 140 hertz. Now my calculator says that it's actually 159 hertz, so I was pretty close. Now we can look at other parts of the curve and see how much filtering there is at different frequencies. Let's take a look at 10 kilohertz. Look at the bottom left corner. 9.7, move it up a little bit, trace the line. There we go. So at 10 kilohertz, we've got 16 millivolts out from 1 volt in. That's a large amount of attenuation. So this filter is very good at filtering out 10 kilohertz. Now if we want to do even more filtering, we just need to change the component values over here. So let's change that capacitor, make it 100 microfarads. Let's close this. Let's run the simulation again. Click the output node. And wow, pretty much everything gets filtered. Let's change the vertical axis to volts again. Right-click, manual limits, from decibels to logarithmic, top, make that 2 volts, leave that bottom one as a tiny number. You can see that at 10 hertz, we're already down to 185 millivolts. So this is a very good low-pass filter. Okay, let's move on to a more interesting example. Let's close up everything here. Nope. And start a new schematic.